All right, guys, we're working on Joe Capola's 2003 Volvo S60 non-turbo, and we're going to complete a timing belt job. Let's start. I like to make things easier for myself. We're going to take off the cross brace. It's going to be a 15 millimeter and an 18 millimeter. It's going to be a 14 millimeter on both sides. It's going to be a total of four. Take those off. Please watch out, sometimes there's a zip tie here holding the power steering line up. Discard it. Take that bar off, put it to the side. Next could be a T30. Take off one of the timing covers. It's gonna be two clips in the side. One here, one down here. Push them away, pull the cover out, and put that aside. We're gonna pop power steering reservoir up. Loosen this bracket over here. I'm gonna move that reservoir to the side. Make sure the top's on so nothing leaks. Next, what I like to do is I like to take the overflow hose off of the reservoir. We're gonna get that out of the way. Your pinch off pliers, pinch off the hose. This is coolant, I like to do it twice. Always remove the cap first in case there's any type of pressure in the system. Put it back on. Gently pull up. Just when you flip this up, use some kind of like a putty just to cover that hole if you don't have any type of plug. Just go lift it. Be careful, you're going to want to disconnect the level sensor. Pull the plug in the level sensor and you can move that reservoir right out of your way. Next step, you're going to want to take off your serpentine belt. We're actually going to replace Joe's since we're in here. It's not a bad idea. This is a 14 millimeter. Loosen the tension. Take the belt off. Let it go. Very simple. Next, we're going to loosen the timing belt cover bolt, 10 millimeter bolt. Put it off to the side in a safe place. There's little tabs here on the side of the timing cover. I'm gonna get to those later. Make sure you pop those out. And also down there, if you look down on the bottom, it's also gonna tuck behind the crankshaft. Just pull that cover straight out, set it to the side. Now we have the timing cover off, we're gonna lift the car. We're gonna go underneath, take the wheel off and the cover, and you'll gain access to your crankshaft pulley. I'll show you how it's done. All right, we got the wheel off now. You're gonna notice there's a panel here, plastic nuts. Be careful with them. Just take those two nuts off. Two nuts to the side. Put that plate in a safe place. What I like to do now, get some vice grips. Hold it, you're gonna notice there's a crease already on this fender liner. Hold it right in the crease. You can crimp it. It's gonna stay out of your way now. Now what we're gonna wanna do is we're gonna wanna put back the top cover, and because your timing mark, alignment marks are here. So what you're gonna wanna do is align the marks on the camshaft to the marks on the timing cover. We'll do that now. We're gonna be moving these reservoirs around a lot. They're just constantly in the way. You're gonna want to grab your half-inch breaker, a 30 millimeter socket, come down here on the crankshaft,
you're always going to want to turn the engine clockwise.
So we're going to turn the engine clockwise now
to align the teeth marks. One of them's here. We're pretty close already. The other one is right over here. There's small little notches on the camshaft pulley. So basically, we're going to want to move the notches on your camshaft pulley. This is your intake camshaft, your exhaust camshaft. We're going to want to move it clockwise until it reaches this point here. So basically, it's going to be in sync with one another. You're going to have the mark on the camshaft in sync with the mark on the timing cover. Let's do that now. It looks pretty good on intake camshaft. We're gonna check the mark on the exhaust. Looks like it's just a hair over, so we wanna come back, just a hair. See now the mark on the camshaft, on the exhaust camshaft is lined up with the mark on the cover. Same thing with your intake camshaft. All right, so now we have our camshaft marks aligned to the timing cover. There's one more mark, it's on the bottom of the crankshaft. You're gonna notice that there's gonna be two teeth to have markings in, similar to the marking that's on your camshaft here. You're gonna find those two teeth and you're gonna compare, there's gonna be a notch on the block itself. So basically you want the notch in the block to be right in the center of the two teeth on the crankshaft. All right, we're gonna go ahead and remove our crankshaft pulley now. There's gonna be four 10 millimeter bolts and one 30 millimeter. Once you take this nut off, it's gonna put pressure on the crank. It may have a tendency to turn it just a slight bit. Once you get it off, you wanna make sure your marks are still aligned properly. Because this is down there for so long, you might get some kind of corrosion there. I like to use a penetrating oil, let it soak for just a bit. You can use a rubber mallet just to slightly tap the pulley. You'll see, you'll slowly be able to walk it side to side and then eventually off. Alright, now we verified that the marks for your camshaft are in the right spot, and same thing with your crankshaft. After we took off the crankshaft pulley, we're going to go ahead and remove the top cover again. So, the reservoir is off to the side, yet again. Take off that top cover, place to the side, again. Move the reservoir back to the side. Take a 12 millimeter wrench. Go down to the tensioner here. We're gonna loosen up the bolt. Doesn't need to be pulled out. I probably have 2/4 turns on that. What I like to do is, I like to move this. This is the tension arm. I like to move that to the right. It relieves the tension. I like to get the belt off from this side once you pull the tension. It's very good we're doing this. A good indication that this belt was about to fail are the stress cracks. You can see these cracks. See that, how it opens right up? This belt would have failed within the next 5,000 or less.
Go ahead.
Since you have this off, some of the timing belt kits that we sell do come with a water pump. This is a perfect time to inspect the condition of your water pump. Some people prefer to replace it now at this time since you're in there. It's just 7 bolts if you want to do it. Joe's looks fine, it's not leaking, it's in very good shape. The bearing doesn't have any play to it, it's not making any noise. So we're gonna go ahead and leave it be today. Okay, now we're gonna go ahead and replace the idler. As you can see, it mounts in this position. You're gonna have one bolt up here, one down below. It's gonna be hard to see the one down below, so you're gonna have to feel for it. 12 millimeter bolt. I'm gonna go for that difficult one first. Feel the socket on the bolt, you'll hear it click just like it just did. Loosen that bolt. Go with the top one. I like to back them off a few turns and get the rest by hand later. Loosen that top one. could see some debris was starting to come out of that idler pulley, this is a great time to change it.
Well, you have the old one out. Go ahead and compare the parts that you're putting on the car versus the ones you took off the car. Just make sure the diameter of the pulley is the same. The mounting holes are in the same position. This one looks good. We got the go ahead. And replace the two bolts for that idler pulley. Next, we're going to remove the time belt tensioner itself. We already cracked it loose, so just go ahead and back the bolt out by hand. All right, we have the time belt tensioner off. Notice how there's some debris coming out of the tensioner pulley. The bearing itself is a good time. If you spin it, you could hear. It's time. This is about to let go as well. And these are a little bit complicated once you're down there. Basically, you want to thread this up, but you want to leave the center bolt loose. This is going to be when you start, it's going to be in 11 o'clock position. some of these, depending on the engine number, there's a variation in the newer models. You got to bring this notch up around 2 o'clock. This one has to be below that certain engine number. So this one we have to bring down actually at 7 o'clock. I'll show you what I mean when we get down there. Now your tensioner's in place, you want to make sure that the notch on the block sits right in the notch on the tensioner. What I like to do first is I like to loop it around the crankshaft. I like to hold in this position and gently tug up on both ends just to make sure that the teeth are sitting in the grooves on the crankshaft pulley itself. Seems to be good. Okay, so all I can do now is hold tension on the left side here, and what we're going to do is we're going to guide the belt around this side, constantly holding tension. We're going to wrap it around the intake cam gear. Once that side's tight, you're gonna wrap it around the tensioner pulley, wrap it around the water pump, and hold tension right here at your exhaust camshaft pulley. What I like to do now, there's a tension arm on the tensioner itself. You can move that all the way to the right. It's a little secret I learned. That's gonna give you as much free play as possible to wrap the time belt on the exhaust camshaft itself, just like that. So now it's in, it's not tensioned yet, but just go around and make sure all the teeth are sitting in the correct grooves on all the gear, on the camshaft gears, on your crank gear, water pump gear. Seems to be fine. Before you go ahead and tension the belt, what you're going to want to do is you're going to want to make sure these camshaft pulleys did not move. You're going to want to put that cover back on. So, move these reservoirs out of the way. Put this cover back on. It looks like it moved a little bit, so we're gonna have to redo this. Be very careful with this. Okay, now our alignment marks are perfect. We're gonna go ahead and we're gonna tighten up that belt now. You're gonna need a 6 millimeter Allen. You're gonna fit it right onto the tensioner. And right now we're in the 11 o'clock position.
It's right here. We want to move this down to the 7 o'clock position. Your center screw is still going to be, you know, just less than finger tight, still going to be a little bit loose. We're going to go ahead and move that down to 7 o'clock. So we're going to do that now. And once we move it, you're going to notice temperature indicator. It's going to move past. You're going to want to go past the notches. And then you're going to want to go back. Right now it's about 6 o'clock. Move it back to the 7 o'clock position. While it's in the 7 o'clock, you're going to want to go ahead and tighten down that center screw. Basically, what we want to do is, you know, we started off in 11 o'clock position. We want to move this to 7. While you're doing this and there's actual tension on it, you're going to notice this arm here is the temperature arm. It's going to move past. Once it moves past, you want to come back to it. You want it to sit, if you're at room temperature between like 68 degrees, you know, 65, 68 to 70 degrees, you want it to sit right in the middle. Now that your marks are aligned, you want to turn the engine over. Make sure they end up in the same place again. Make sure there's no resistance, meaning, you know, you have a valve on piston contact. And also you want to verify that the tension in your belt is in good order and the tension is in the correct spot. So we're going to do that now. Like turn it twice. All right, so now we verified that our marks are in the correct position. Our crankshaft marks there, our exhaust cam and our intake camshaft are in the correct marks. Everything's tight. If you just want to go over it this time, make sure your bolts are tight for your tensioner and your idler, those three bolts all together. Make sure the time belt is walking in a proper place. What I mean by that is make sure that it's centered on all the pulleys and it's not off to the right or to the left or hanging off a little bit. Everything looks good, so we're gonna go ahead and we're gonna take off the top upper cover. We're gonna go ahead and install the side cover. You're gonna hear it clip in. You can actually verify, if you look on the side here, you'll see the clip, so you know it's clipped in here. You heard it snap in on the other side. Go ahead and replace your center bolt. So we got our cover on. We're gonna take the upper cover, place the upper cover back in its place. Here, both sides snap in. Place the two screws, T30s. Put our serpentine belt back on. Remember, get down in the area. What I like to do is put it around the AC compressor and the crankshaft pulley, like so. Reach down below, grab it. Make sure it's still wrapped around your AC compressor. You're going to take the loop that you just pulled up. You're going to wrap it around your alternator. Wrap it around your serpentine belt tensioner. Hold the tensioner up top at your power steering pulley. You can use
use a 14 millimeter wrench or a serpentine belt tool if you have it. Get on the tensioner. Release that tension. Pop that belt right on. After the belt's on, verify again that the belt is inside all the grooves on all the pulleys, your AC compressor, your alternator, your power steering, the serpentine belt tensioner, and your crankshaft pulley, which it is. Now we can start putting back our reservoirs. Coolant first, don't forget, the level sensor, plug that back in. Get a new clamp for your overflow. That semi on there, you could take your pinch off pliers off, put on the rest of the way. If you look here, the clips sit directly into those grooves. You just put it straight down, it's gonna sit right in there. Tighten your clamp. Alright, now we got our coolant reservoir on. Time to replace our power steering reservoir. That snap right back in. Replace our bracket here. Make sure the hose is far enough away from the serpentine belt. I've seen some times where this is actually sagging and the hose will actually rub on the serpentine belt. Causes a big mess. You don't want to do that.
After you put your wheel back on, come on, put the top strut brace on. Always thread these bolts in by hand just to get them started. Make sure you don't cross thread. Cross bolt on the torque arm bushing. And the end protector. Don't forget the zip tie for your power steering hose. All right, so that about does it. We're done with the time belt, and I hope you guys learned something. Please visit our YouTube channel. Any questions, give us a call, 877-634-0063. Thanks.